Feminist Creativus presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings, my brothers and sisters. I hope the Lord has been good and gracious unto you. We have one more mountain experience as we drink from the well of wisdom. Come with me to the book of Deuteronomy, and we begin at chapter 2, and we'll read from verse number 2. It reads as follows. And the Lord spake unto me, saying, verse 3, ye have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn you northward. Verse 4, and command thou the people, saying, ye are to pass through the coast of your brethren, the children of Esau, which dwell in Seir, and they shall be afraid of you. Take ye good heed unto yourselves thereof. Verse 5, meddle not with them, for I will not give you of their land. No, not so much as a foot breadth, because I have given Mount Seir unto Esau for a possession. Verse 6, ye shall buy meat of them for money, that ye may eat. And ye shall also buy water of them for money, that ye may drink. Verse 7, for the Lord thy God had blessed thee in all the works of thy hand. He knoweth thy walking through this great wilderness. These 40 years the Lord thy God hath been with thee. Thou hast lacked nothing. May the good Lord bless the reading of his word as we spend a moment in prayer. Come join Mr. MK as we pray. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord. We praise your name, for we have lacked nothing. We praise your name, for you have provided for us. We praise your name, for you keep us in motion. Dear Father, as we go into thy word, how we pray that your presence may continue to lead us, continue to guide us, and in all we do or say, may we return the glory, the praise, and the honor unto your name on high. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask, amen. My dear friends, just allow me to raise 5 points as usual. And the word of the Lord is so much fun to consider. Listen to God as he speaks to Moses in verse number 3. He says, you have been camped around Mount Seir for far too long. You have been here for too long. God is speaking to the children of Moses, and may I talk to someone who is in a workspace this morning. And I'm saying, perchance, you have been in one station for far too long. God is saying, I'm about to move you, my child. God takes not. God takes not, and he counts the days, the years, the months, and the decades. We are in the same position, and he says, enough is enough. It is time to move. As the Lord moves you this weekend, as the Lord moves you this week, as the Lord moves you this month, take time to walk with confidence. Walk with confidence. At point number 2, he says, as you're going to walk past, you're going to pass by the coast of Seir. Thereat, you're going to meet the children of Esau. These are your cousins. And he says at verse 4, they are going to be afraid of you. Even though they are going to be afraid of you, take not. You do well not to be afraid yourselves. There shall come a moment then when you are in progression, as the Lord takes you from one station to the next, people may become afraid of you. Some will be intimidated by your presence as you go about your business, as you head off to your next station, as you head off to your next post. People may become intimidated by your presence. Should it so happen to you this week, take note, you are a child of God. You are in the presence of God. Wherever you go, you unsettle people. There's nothing you can do about it. All you can do is make sure that you do not cause them any undue harm or any undue concern. Because point number 3 has this to say, as you look at verse number 5, God says unto them, do not meddle with them. I'll read this again, meddle not with them, for I will not give you any of their land. You know, there are some people who make it a habit that because God is on my side, now they make themselves busybodies. They go about inserting themselves into the lives of others. God says, now that you are with me, now that we're working together, make it a habit not to meddle in the affairs of other people. God has not blessed you with what is in the hands of others. He will give you what is yours. Do not go to the children of Esau seeking their land. God has given it unto them. May I talk to those who are in positions? Do not be going for someone else's position. They are a child of Esau. God has given them that position. He'll give you your own. Go home. Do not be going after somebody's wife. She is out of bounds. Do not go after someone's husband. They are out of bounds. God has not even given you the foot's breadth. It is not yours. God can still bless you in your own space. Stay in your lane and continue on your way from Sir to Canaan. That is where you are headed. Point number four. I love this. Look at verse 6. Allow me to read this one, especially for my African brothers and sisters. Verse 6 says, before I make the point, you shall buy meat of them for money that you may eat. You shall buy water of them for money that you may drink. What am I saying here? You know, we have our cousins and brothers, but every time we walk into their business spaces, we want to get freebies. We don't want to pay. God says, child of Jacob, as you meet the children of Esau, support them financially. They need support. We are so keen to go and buy from Canaan, but we will not buy from the children of Esau. Why can't we buy from our own cousins? Why can't we buy from our own family members? I know. As Africans, we think it is not proper for you to sell to your relatives, to sell to your neighbors. But who is going to buy from our brothers? Who is going to buy from our neighbors if we do not buy from them? Who is going to support them financially if we do not support them? So God says unto Moses, go and command them. There is nothing wrong with you financially establishing your brothers and sisters. Buy from them and be on your way. You are not going to suffer. You are not going to go hungry. After all, at point number 5, as we come to the climax, God then says, children of Israel, I'm actually sending you on a shopping spree. You have been in the desert for 40 years. Imagine coming out of the desert with money to spend out of the desert. Can you imagine people who have been sojourners for 40 years? They're coming to your door and they have money to spend. Isn't this a blessing? God says unto them, I need to remind you, you have lacked nothing so far. Do not turn into beggars. I have kept you. Do not turn into ungrateful people. I have blessed you. As you walk out tall to your brothers and spend money like someone who's coming from a voyage, someone who has hid a treasure, as if you have a treasure trove. Go out there and buy. Do not embarrass me by being beggars. Go out and you have lacked nothing in the wilderness. How can you lack when you are living the wilderness now? You have had plenty in times of trouble. How can you have less in times of peace? I want to pray with you, my dear friends, that the Lord may remind us that we have lacked nothing, that the Lord may keep us in the safe and hollow of His hand, continue to provide for us, to spend, and even establish the businesses of our brothers. A moment to pray. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of learning from your word. Off we go into our workspaces. We'll meet our brothers and sisters. Help us to not compete with them. Help us not to not deprive them of what you have set in their hands, what you have blessed them with. As we bless them, remind us how you have blessed us too. So that as we look at our lives and what we can afford, it may not be much, for we can only buy meat and water. But dear Lord, from the wilderness experience, we learn you have been with us. It's been 40 years. Continue to be with us and lead us from one position to the next. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask, Amen.